Principal subject. Today I am going to explain you capstan lathe and turret lathe. What are capstan lathes? What are the turret lathes? What is the importance of capstan and turret lathes? What is the difference between capstan and turret lathes? Today we are going to discuss. So coming to this is a capstan lathe. So this is a capstan lathe. So in most of the cases, capstan lathe and turret lathes are mainly used for mass productions. In cone pulley lathe machines, all grade lathe machines, we are using only 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 cutting tools are we are using. Whereas in capstan and turret lathes, we are using number of cutting tools at a time on the workpiece. Number of cutting tools can be placed on device that is called as turret head. Okay, start chamber. Upward start. So this is a turret head. This turret head having number of cutting tools 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 number of cutting tools are mounted on the workpiece at a time. So this in due to this point we are increasing mass production on the given workpiece. So if you want to get more number of workpieces in a less time, you can use capstan lathe as well as the turret lathe. So capstan lathes or turret lathes are coming under semi-automatic lathes. So capstan lathes and turret lathes are, whereas capstan lathes are lighter in construction, turret lathes are, construction is very high, rigid construction is there. Whereas here, the rigidity of the machine is, in capstan lathe, the rigidity of the machine is very less compared to turret lathe machine. Compared to turret lathe machine, this cost of the machine also very less. Turret lathe cost of the machine is very high. This is the very less cost when compared to turret lathe machines. So coming to, so in this particular machine, we can fix the workpiece on a collet chains. We can fix the machine workpieces. So this is a workpiece. We can fix the workpiece in a collet chains. In capstan lathes, we can fix the workpieces in collet checks, whereas in turret lathes, we can fix the workpiece in 3-jaw checks and 4-jaw checks. Okay. Ippudu ee point gunchi maatladam, ee turret head gunchi maatladam. So there is a, in capstan lathe, the main important point is the turret head can be placed on a ram. So this is a turret head, this is the auxiliary. Auxiliary plate, sometimes it is called as auxiliary plate, sometimes it is called as ram. So turret head can be placed on a ram. So ram can be placed on saddle. So saddle can be fixed on lathe bed. So these are the fixers which by using these fixers and nuts and bolts, we can fix the ram on a lathe at a particular point. But here the ram can be moved. The tool travel is very less in this particular machine. So when compared to turret lathe machine, the tool travel is very less. So here, by using this star handle, we can change the position of the cutting tools by using this star handle. So we can, in this way, we can change the position of the cutting tools. So if you want, if you want to produce a drilling operation over this, you can use drilling tool. If you want to produce a knurling operation, you can use knurling tool. If you want to produce a turning operation on a given workpiece, you can use turning tool. So in this way, you have to produce number of operations on a given workpiece in very less time. So due to this reason, we can increase mass production. Whereas in turret lathe machine, the turret head can be turret head directly placed on a saddle. There is no ram arrangement in turret lathe machines. The turret head directly placed on a saddle. In turret lathe machines, the saddle can be moved. When saddle moves, the turret head also moves. The tool travel is very high in turret lathe machines. Whereas in capstan lathe machine, the turret head directly placed on a ram. So this part is called as ram or auxiliary plate. This is the saddle. Saddle can be fixed on a table. So in this way, these are some of the main construction of capstan lathe machines.
Right.
So by using this lever, check collet on and off lever, we can remove the workpiece from the collet. We can tighten the workpiece as well as we can loosen the workpiece by using this lever. So by using this lever, we can tighten and loosen the workpiece. So in this way we can tie the workpiece and call it. So we have one carriage is there. So this is a carriage. So this carriage is called, actually we have two types of carriages are there. One is side hung carriage, one more is reach out type carriage. In turret lathe machines, we are using side hung carriages as well as reach out type carriages. Whereas in capstan lathe, most of the cases we are using reach over type carriages. This is a reach over type carriage. So in reach over type carriage, we have two cross lathes. So one is front cross lathe and the one is rear cross lathe. These tool posts can be placed on the cross lathe. This is a cross lathe. This is a tool post. In the tool post, we are fixing the cutting tools. So in this way, we can use number of cutting tools on a workpiece. So number of cutting tools can be mounted on a workpiece. One more important point in capstan lathes and turret lathes, there is no tailstock in. There is no tailstock in capstan and turret lathes. Instead of tailstock, we are using turret head. So instead of in the position of the tailstock, we are placing turret head. That is the one of the important thing in capstan and turret lathe machines. In this machine, we can machine very, very short length workpieces only. The maximum length of the diameter, length of the workpiece is very less. When compared to turret length machines, turret length machines are used for long length jobs. Whereas capstan lathes are used for machining of short length jobs. The maximum diameter of the workpiece here in this machine, actually in this machine we are using 25 mm diameter, but most of the cases we are using up to 60 mm diameter. We can use capstan lathe machines. Whereas in turret lathe machine, the maximum diameter of the workpiece is 200 mm. So that is the one of the important thing in capstan and turret lathe machine. Coming to saddle, the saddle cannot be moved in capstan lathe machine. Whereas in turret lathe machine, the saddle is moved. Here the saddle is tightly fixed on the lathe bed. So that is the one of the thing in capstan lathes. So now we will discuss what are the important parts of a capstan lathe machine. We will see. This is a headstock. As we know that headstock mainly used for power transmission of all the parts and power transmission of or movement of spindle. So movement of the checks, movement of the workpiece, we are using headstock. I don't want to discuss all the full details of the parts. If you want the full details, I'll give you the link in description. So coming to one more part, that is the turret head. This is the ram. This is the saddle. This is the star handle. This is the carriage. This is actually reach over type carriage. So this is the cross line. So these are the tool posts. So this is a collet. This is headstock. This is on and off lever. This is an emergency switch. This is on and off. This is a coolant pump on and off. Coolant pump switch. So this is the base. This is the base which is provided in this particular machine. This is the coolant pump lever. So if you want the coolant, you can use this pump. So these are the main important points, important parts of a capstan lathe machine. So now we will see what is the working of a capstan lathe machine. How the working is happening, we will see. Let's come to the working of a capstan lathe machine. So now we are changing the position of the cutting tool. Now I want to produce a drilling operation on a given workpiece. So now I can change the position of the drilling tool. So now I want the position of the drill bit here. So now I contact the drill bit with the workpiece. Then I can produce drilling operation. So in this way we can produce drilling operation on a given workpiece. Now we will see drilling operation. So in this way I can produce drilling operation on a given workpiece. So now you can see how the drilling operation is produced on the given workpiece. So in this way we can produce drills on a given workpiece. So now we will do turning operation on a given workpiece using capstan lathe. So this is a turning operation. Okay. In this way we can produce turning operation on a capstan lathe machine.
this is the output of turning operation on a given workpiece.
Doing knurling operation on a given workpiece, how I am adjusting the knurling tool with the workpiece. So in this way, this is the knurling tool. Knurling tool adjusted with the workpiece. So in this way, we can adjust the knurling tool with the workpiece. Now let me see how the operation is going to be done.
Right. So now we will do knurling operation on a given workpiece using the capstan lathe machine. You can start. So now I am contacting these are the knurling rollers. This is the diamond knurling roller. So in this way I am doing knurling operation on a given workpiece. So these are So in this way, this is the final output of knurling object. So in this way, we are producing knurling operation on a given workpiece. So in
this way, we are doing number of operations on a capstan lathe machine. So now we will discuss what is a turret lathe machine. What is the difference between capstan and turret lathe machine? We will discuss right now.
So coming to capstan lathe machines and turret lathe machines. So coming to the turret lathe machine. So turret lathe is a form of metal working lathe that is used for repetitive production of duplicate parts, which by nature of their cutting process are usually interchangeable. And it has additional turret, which is indexable tool holder that allows multiple cutting operations to be performed, each with a different cutting tool. And the third point, need for the operator to perform set of tasks in between, such as installing or uninstalling tools, is not required. The turret head is directly mounted on the saddle and the saddle slides over the bedways. Saddle is moved to provide feed to the tool and they are heavy and durable. More feed and depth of cut are provided for machining. It is used for mass production of large size equal parts. It is accommodated with power checks. So this is all about, this is a figure of turret lathe machine. These are all the figures of turret lathe machines. So both turret lathe machines as well as the capstan lathe machines are coming under semi-automatic lathe machines. So now we will see what is the main difference between capstan and turret lathe machines. So in capstan lathe machine, it is a light duty machine, whereas the turret lathe machine, it is a heavy duty machine. Whereas in capstan lathe machine, the turret head is mounted on a ram and the ram is mounted on a saddle. Whereas in turret lathe machine, the turret head is directly mounted on the saddle and the saddle slides over the bedways. Coming to the third point, the saddle will not be moved during the machining. The lengthwise movement of the turret is less, the lengthwise movement of the turret is more. In capstan lathe machines, as I already told you that short workpieces only can be machined, long workpieces can be machined in turret lathe machines. It is easy to move turret head as it slides over the ram. In turret lathe machines, it is difficult to move the turret head along with the saddle. Whereas in capstan lathe machine, the turret head cannot be moved crosswise. The turret head can be moved crosswise direction. Whereas in capstan lathe machine, as the construction of the lathe is not rigid, heavy cuts are cannot be given in capstan lathe machine. Heavy cuts are easily given by the turret lathe machines. In capstan lathe machine, we can use machining of workpieces up to 60 mm diameter. Here in turret lathe machine, we can machine the workpiece up to 200 mm diameter. Here, for holding of the workpieces, in capstan lathe machines, we are using collet checks, whereas in turret lathe machines, we are using 3-jaw checks and 4-jaw checks. So this is the difference between capstan and turret lathe machine. So the figures of capstan and turret lathe machines are also provided here. So hope you guys are enjoyed. Thank you for your watching. Please share, subscribe and comment. If you have any doubts, comment in comment section. Thank you. Yours, Paulayya Chintada.